Hello and welcome. My name is Abhishek Hemrajani. In this video, I'll walk you through the process of large-scale migration of VMware virtual machines to Azure with Azure Migrate's inbuilt server assessment and server migration capabilities. But before we start, let's talk through the process. We will start off by deploying the Azure Migrate appliance in the on-premises data center. Once the appliance is up and running, it will be able to start performing discovery and analysis of performance data for Windows and Linux machines that are running in the data center. That information is going to help us create assessments before we are ready to actually migrate our Windows or Linux virtual machines to Azure with the server migration capability. Let's get started. So here I am on the Azure portal, and I have browsed to my Azure Migrate overview. In one of my previous videos, we created a new Azure Migrate project and activated the server assessment and server migration tools to perform our server migration scenarios. We could have also used the integrated ISV options that are available with Azure Migrate. With server assessment selected as the discovery and assessment tool, I'm ready to get started with the discover process. Click on Discover. I now get the option of downloading the Azure Migrate appliance for my VMware environment. Clicking on the download option will give me the Azure Migrate appliance in an open virtualization format, which I can then import into my vCenter environment to create a virtual machine for the appliance. Azure Migrate server assessment lets you perform discovery and assessment of up to 35,000 virtual machines from the VMware environment at one go. The documentation provides information on how to configure appliances for a scale environment. So I was able to download the Azure Migrate appliance from the portal. I imported it into my vCenter environment using the vCenter server client. And once the virtual machine was up and running, I was presented with the default configuration experience. As a first step, I need to ensure that prerequisites are in place for me to register my Azure Migrate appliance with the Azure Migrate service. These include ensuring that you have connectivity to the internet via or without a proxy, and making sure that you have the latest Azure Migrate updates installed. For VMware environments, I also need to make sure that the VMware vSphere Virtual Disk Development Kit is installed on the Azure Migrate appliance. The documentation provides comprehensive instructions on how to do these. Our documentation also includes prerequisite scripts and a prerequisites checklist. In my experience, customers who've completed their prerequisites before they get started with Azure Migrate have the best experience onboarding to the product. At this point, I need to ensure that I am able to log into my Azure account. Once the login is successful, I'll then be able to see the subscriptions that I have access to. I'm going to use my demo subscription. I can then select the Azure Migrate project that I want this appliance to register to. I had created the Contoso project in one of my previous videos. I'll name this appliance Appliance 1 and click on Register. The registration process will take a few quick minutes to complete. Once the registration is successful, click on Continue. You can then provide the vCenter server details. Provide the username and the password. Click on Validate Connection to ensure that the credentials are correct. As a final step, click on Save and Start Discovery. For the largest of environments, you can have discovery and configuration data available in Azure Migrate within the hour. All right, so back on the Azure portal, I can see that my discovery is complete. I ended up discovering my entire data center of over 35,000 virtual machines with server assessment. I used three appliances to complete this discovery, roughly discovering 12,000 virtual machines per appliance. Now that the configuration and performance data has started coming into the server assessment service, I'm ready to create assessments. Start off by clicking on Assess. As a first step, let's give this assessment a name. I'm going to call it Contoso DC Exit because my intent is to migrate all of my virtual machines to Azure. As part of the assessment, I need to create a group of all my virtual machines. I'm going to call the group Contoso DC Exit as well. And finally, I'm going to select all my virtual machines to be part of this one group. Clicking on Create Assessment will create the group and also generate the assessment for the entire group. Now, this assessment will get created with the default assessment properties. You can click on View All to review all the properties and select the ones that may be applicable for you. Our documentation provides a comprehensive explanation for all of these settings. One setting that I want to specifically call out is the sizing criterion. You have the option of creating an as on-premises assessment or a performance-based assessment. When you select the performance-based assessment option, performance data profiled from your virtual machines is factored into the assessment recommendation. This ensures that you're migrating your virtual machines with the most optimized SKU that meets the performance requirements of your application. It also helps you save money as part of the migration process. Performance history can be factored in at a 1 day, a 1 week, or a 1 month granularity. For applications that demonstrate seasonality over a week or over a month, we recommend selecting the appropriate settings. Now that we've reviewed the assessment settings, let's click on Create Assessment and generate the group and the assessment. All right, on the server assessment overview, I can now see that I have my Contoso DC exit group and the Contoso DC exit assessment created. The assessment is ready, meaning it has been computed with the properties that I specified as part of the creation process. Notice that the assessment still has a 1-star confidence rating. This is because I'm creating a performance-based assessment. You want to wait for a sufficient amount of time for performance data to come into the system to create the assessment. You can always recompute the same assessment and you will find that the confidence rating will keep climbing, eventually getting to a 5-star rating. Let's look at some of the information that this assessment provides. So I simply click on assessment. I can see that the assessment overview gives me information such as readiness of my virtual machines for migration to Azure. It also tells me my cost estimates from a compute and a storage perspective. You can drill down into the readiness and cost information for every single machine. Overall, I'm very happy with my assessment. A majority of my virtual machines are already ready for Azure. With that, I'm ready to perform migrations. Click on Azure Migrate Servers. That brings you back to the server's experience in Azure Migrate. To walk you through the process of performing migration on top of this discovered inventory, I created one additional group called Contoso Payroll, and I also computed an assessment for that group. That group has 9 virtual machines. Notice that the server assessment tile in Azure Migrate gets updated with the latest information of whatever is happening in any of the connected tools. This functionality works the same for Microsoft and ISV tools. With that, I'm ready to start migrating. Simply click on Replicate in Server Migration. As a first step, I'm going to indicate that I want to migrate my VMware virtual machines. I'm also going to specify the specific appliance that I want to use for migration of those virtual machines. This is where things get really interesting. With our new integrated end-to-end experience, you now have the ability to import settings from an assessment that you've previously computed. You can also import settings from any of the ISV tools. I'm going to go ahead and say yes, apply my migration settings from the Azure Migrate assessment. I can then pick the group that I want to perform the migration on. I created a new Contoso payroll group for this particular video. I then get the option of picking the specific assessment that I want to use for the migration. This feature has the benefit that every single recommendation from the assessment, either from the Microsoft tools recommendation or from the ISV tools recommendation, is automatically applied to the migration process. That ensures that you're migrating in the most optimized manner. I'll select the 9 virtual machines that are part of this group to perform the migration. On the next tab, I get to provide the target settings for the migration. I can choose to migrate to any Azure data center of my choice. I can also specify the subscription and the resource group that I want my virtual machines to get migrated to, and the virtual network and the specific subnet that I want my virtual machines to be connected to post-migration. Click Next for Compute. On this screen, you'll notice that your assessment details have automatically been applied to all the virtual machines. The disk recommendations get automatically applied as well. On the final tab, you can review the details before you start replicating your machines to Azure. We are using an agentless method to migrate VMware virtual machines from on-premises to Azure in this case. Clicking on Replicate brings me back to the server's experience in Azure Migrate. I can also see that the server migration tile in Azure Migrate has been updated with the latest information. I now have 9 virtual machines from my Contoso payroll app replicating to Azure. I can take quick actions on these virtual machines, including migrating them to Azure, or click on Overview to see things in better detail. From the server migration overview, I can perform test migration on my virtual machines. This will ensure that my application is brought up in an isolated network in Azure. I can validate the performance of the application before I decide to perform a migration to Azure. It's as simple as that. All right, folks, that's what I had for you in this video. But before we end, let's quickly recap. In this video, we saw how easy it is to get started with Azure Migrate Server Assessment and Server Migration. We started by deploying the Azure Migrate appliance in our vSphere environment. We were able to discover over 35,000 virtual machines. We created a group and then also computed an assessment on top of the group. When it came to performing migration, all of our assessment recommendations automatically were applied to the migration phase. And finally, with test migration, we saw that you have the ability to validate the performance of your right-sized apps before you decide to migrate them to Azure. I hope you found this video useful. Thank you and keep watching.